Hi, good morning. Today we're going to revise on normal tech science 2014 magnetism. Okay, this is our syllabus for this year only. First of all, we would like to distinguish what is magnetic and non-magnetic materials. So what are non-magnetic materials and what are magnetic materials? Now, magnetic materials means that the material can be magnetized. Non-magnetic materials would mean that the materials cannot be magnetized. An example of magnetic materials would be iron, steel, cobalt, and nickel. All these four materials can be magnetized. Non-magnetic materials, example, would be paper, glass, plastic, copper. Now, copper, although is a metal, it is usually misunderstood, mistaken that it's a magnetic material. Alright, copper cannot be magnetized even though it's a metal. So please take note. Alright, copper. So usually only these four metals can be magnetized. Copper is non-magnetic. Now next, we want to know how do we magnetize something, right? How to magnetize something? How to, right? How to magnetize something? There are two methods. The first method, we use a DC, and then we connect to a coil. So if we switch on, a current will flow, right? So the current will flow from the plus. Alright, through this coil. Now this is a copper wire coil, so we call this a coil or solenoid. If we want to magnetize something, we put the material inside here, and this will be magnetized when the current flow around it. Alright, flow around it. So this is using DC, right? Using DC. Direct current. Another way to magnetize is to use the stroking method. So we use a permanent magnet and we stroke on a magnetic material. So if we stroke many times, right, repeatedly many times, this will become a south pole and this will become a north pole. So these are two methods to magnetize something. Now what about removing the magnetism? Demagnetize. If you want to remove the magnetism, alright, what do we do? We have two methods using the AC. The first method using the AC. Now AC means alternating current. It actually means that the current in the circuit will changes direction repeatedly. So one of them will be a live, one of them will be a neutral. If we want to demagnetize something, we put the magnet inside and we slowly pull out. Alright, slowly pull out when we switch on the alternating current. So to magnetize, use DC. To demagnetize, use AC. Now another way to demagnetize is to subject the permanent magnet to heat. Okay, the last portion is on the use of permanent magnet and electromagnet. Now, permanent magnet means that the magnetism is retained for a long time. Now, electromagnet, as the name suggests, it is only a magnet when we switch on the circuit and the current electricity flow. So this is more of a temporary magnet. Alright? Permanent magnet, like bar magnets, alright, is used in magnetic compasses, used in motors, alright, used in door or cupboard locking mechanism, locking catches. Now, electromagnet it is only a minute when we switch on. So if we switch off, it's no longer a magnet, right? So suppose it's a electromagnet. When we switch on, it can attract things. When we switch off, it cannot attract things. So electromagnet is used in a recycle centers where we separate the magnetic materials from the non-magnetic materials. It is also used as relays. Okay, so this is all about anti-science magnetism for 2014. Thank you.